Good afternoon, everyone. I am honored to be able to speak to all of you who are here today and those watching from the comfort of your own homes. This is such a momentous occasion, and my fellow graduates and I are glad you chose to help us commemorate this moment. Standing in front of all of you today is a bittersweet moment. I'll be honest with you, I am truly sad about leaving Co-Lin. Co-Lin has not only given me an outstanding education, lifelong friends, and unforgettable memories, but it has taught me many important lessons as well. For example, when you have the option to choose between a 7 a.m. or a 12:30 lab, pick the 12:30 lab. I have figured out the key to making the perfect ice cream cone, and let me just say, if you've never had Co-Lin's ice cream, you are missing out. I have also gained new time management skills. There was a time when I would wake up at 7 a.m. for an 8 o'clock class. I've gotten so good at managing my time that I can now wake up at 7:50. You know what? I'll just stop there. On a serious note, choosing Co-Lin is one of the best decisions I've made. In the words of Elizabeth Stogner, Co-Lin is a special place and deserves to be recognized, and I could not agree more. Throughout our time here at Co-Lin, we have continuously heard the statement, the place to be. It's one thing to just use it as a hashtag, but it is another thing to say it and mean it. If you asked every graduate here today why Co-Lin is the place to be, everyone would give you a different answer. Why is that? We are all at the same school, we all sat in the same cafeteria, we all attended the same sporting events. Why would everyone's answer be different? It is because everyone's experience is unique to them. One person may tell you it's the place to be on a nationally ranked softball team. Another person may tell you it's the place to be a part of a family tradition. I would tell you it's the place to be a collegiate athlete, SGA president, and Phi Theta Kappa vice president. It's the place to be me. It's the place to be a part of a family. Over the past 2 years, I have built countless relationships that will last a lifetime. See, Co-Lin is not the type of place you just leave behind. The impact the school and the people have had on my life is too great. I have built strong relationships with teachers who do not just care if I show up to class or not, but also about my future and the impact I can make on society, who have helped me secure summer internships and participate in programs dedicated to my major. Advisors who somehow always have time to talk with me, who have helped me academically and personally with the challenges I have faced during my time here. Coaches who care more about the experience and life lessons to be learned than the wins and losses of the game of basketball. Teammates who have my back on and off the court, and even though we have played our last game together, the memories, the big time wins, and even the losses will forever be in my heart. Friends who come from all over, such as Georgia, Louisiana, Florida, England, and even right here in Mississippi to attend school in Wesson. Friends who I've only known for 2 years or less, yet it feels like we've known each other for all our lives. And Jana Case, the greatest roommate, friend, and teammate that a girl could ask for. Graduates, we are about to embark on a new journey. As you enter the next phase of your life, whether that be school, work, or the armed forces, I challenge you to continue to strive for excellence. The key to success is never settling. If you settle for being average, you hold yourself back from reaching your full potential. It's as simple as having a self-motivated mindset. As you begin to enter the next phase of your life, you'll be surrounded by people whose goals are different from yours. And that's okay, because it is your self-motivation that will carry you where you want to go in life. As a graduate, it is clear that you have begun the process of what it takes to put yourself in the best positions to succeed. I encourage you to continue to do so. Co-Lin has given us the tools to be successful. The foundation has been set. It is up to us to decide how we will implement what we have gained from Co-Lin in our everyday lives. We must remember that the decisions we make, whether good or bad, reflect on the people who have invested in our lives. We must continue to show our appreciation for them by continuing to stay motivated when faced with obstacles and continuing to take the lessons we have learned at home and at Co-Lin to better ourselves and the world around us. We are not the kind of people that allow circumstances, even a pandemic, to keep us from achieving our goal. We have proven that we are capable of rising above in even the most uncertain circumstances. And while I hope we never see another pandemic in our lifetime, because of it, we are prepared for any challenge that awaits us. As we walk across the stage, we are signifying everything that we have overcome. I do not know your journey, and the person sitting next to you may not understand what it took for you to be here today. But just know that you are one step closer to everything you have worked so hard for. To everyone watching today, the names you hear today, I guarantee you will hear again. Finally, I must acknowledge that I have not taken this journey alone. Most importantly, I would like to thank God for leading me to Co-Lin and guiding me along the way. I would like to thank my family for their constant love and support. Without you all, I would not be the young woman I am today. A special thank you to the administration for the opportunity for allowing me to speak. It has been an honor. I would also like to thank all of my teachers, mentors, and coaches for the role you have played in my success. The compassion you have shown me will never be forgotten. Thank you.